Hi community, this is Josephina Bash out here. I wanted to say thank you so much for continuing to be in this growing global community. And I just want to send you my personal love and support during this time. I've heard from many of you because you've messaged me back to my newsletters, and I love hearing how things are going. And as always, if there's any way that I can support you, please do reach out, don't hesitate. I was recently troubled by the news that I saw in the media about a black man being choked and killed to death. This was just another reminder for me of how important it is right now for us as humanity and as an evolving species to remember the power of our heart, to remember to come back into our true loving, compassionate nature, and to the remembrance that we are all one. To remembering our inherent worthiness and the divine majesty that flows through every single cell in our body, which is our divine birthright. So that is why at this time I have chosen to launch my Self-Love Mastery program, because it is a way for all of us to get back into our hearts and to create a really positive ripple effect that I believe will change the planet on a global scale for years and years and years and decades and potentially lifetimes to come. But it all starts with one. And it all starts with you, and it all starts with me. It starts with the individual person. And I've done the work as the person to create this container, this love vortex, this love bubble for us to come into, to heal, to grow, to learn, to create, to be seen, to be celebrated, to practice being expressed in community, and allow ourselves to shed away and let go of baggage and old stories and narratives that keep holding us back through these bullshit BS belief systems that we have used to shape our lives. I'm inviting you to join me in this 8-week evolutionary invitation, because I have developed and refined this love methodology for the past 7 years that I needed 11 years ago when I was facing a life-challenging situation. Different than what we're facing today, but nonetheless, it was still very traumatic and very challenging. At a time when I needed support, there wasn't any. At a time when I needed to talk to someone or to find a resource that I felt like the person could really understand me, that they knew my struggle, they knew how to handle the pain of a past sexual trauma experience, past feelings and experiences of self-hatred, of physical abuse, of verbal abuse, or overeating and having overeating tendencies. All of these were brought up to me 11 years ago when I was diagnosed with pre-cervical cancer and I was going through a very tumultuous breakup where I was at my lowest breaking point around my own worthiness and self-love. I didn't have any. I didn't know how to source it. I didn't even really know what it was. It wasn't even a buzzword back then. So to now it being everywhere and it being not associated to the deeper rooting meaning of cultivating and harnessing the love that you have for yourself within in order to experience the love within yourself without. A little bit of a tongue twister, but it's true. So when I didn't have these resources, I went to Barnes & Noble's looking, sadly, desperately through the aisles, trying to find something to help me choose myself. There was nothing that I could find. There were things about love, there were things about sex, there were things about relationship, a separate section were things in regards to trauma, but all of it felt really dry. It felt very clinical. It didn't actually speak to the strings of my heart. And so I left there with one workbook that was all about self-confidence or self-esteem, and it literally was the self-esteem workbook. And the self-esteem workbook, I took it home, I went through the first chapter, and it just made me feel even more helpless, because as I was reading it, I didn't understand the ideologies. I didn't really understand how I was going to get from point A to point B through the words of this book. My awareness wasn't there. Not only that, my motivation, my inspiration, that fire in my belly to really know how to lead myself in this unknown territory was not lit up. And so I continuously was running myself into circles and circles, trying to teach myself, learn, grow, heal myself at the same time. And it was when I had this deep, hitting my knees to the ground, hallelujah moment, where I prayed so deeply for some support to be filled up with strength because I was so weak that I didn't know how to fill myself up, did the answer start to come through meditation. I remember where I was exactly. I was in my living room and I had put on something by Deepak Chopra and it was all around his 7 spiritual laws to success. And I started listening to a meditation and the first thing he mentioned was slowing down my breath to breathe and to attune to all of the love and all of the creation energy that exists in this moment. And I remember sitting on my deck outside trying to listen to the birds, trying to slow down my breath, and feeling so ridiculous because I didn't know how to do it. But with practice, I started showing up every day. As I showed up every day, I started to become aware of the sounds, of the sensations. My mind started to slow down, my breath started to deepen, and suddenly in that moment, I can recognize that there was another voice inside that was speaking and running as the captain of my life ship, gearing me up and steering me through fear. It was when I realized that I then could reclaim my power and rewrite my story and reorient what I wanted to believe. It was this mindset and mind-body connection that was my guiding light to fueling me up where I could heal myself. It was a mindset reframe. It was a body activation and connection. It was a prayer practice. It was changing every habit that I had into one that was supporting my health. And sure enough, after a year and a half of diligency and practicing through meditation, through taking up yoga, through doing self-study practices with Tantra and the Taoism of sacred sexuality, could I learn a new framework of reference and reframe the way that I was viewing myself and the world. And I know how pivotal that was for me, because if I didn't have that devotion and I didn't get that fire in my belly lit through a life-changing and a life-threatening circumstance, like being faced with pre-cervical cancer and having cancerous cells in my body, which is a manifestation of repressed emotion, of repressed sexual energy, of lack of self-love and worthiness and self-criticism, I truly believe that all ailments are a physical manifestation of emotional, mental, and psychological, spiritual unresolved issues that we hold inside of ourselves. And that is why I was woken up in the middle of the night at 5 a.m. in 2013, years after I had healed myself, and I received this specific acronym of L-O-V-E, Love Method. It was very clear. I sat and I wrote for hours and hours. I canceled my work that day when I was working for a celebrity branding and development firm. And I chose to just devote myself to receiving the messages, the very clear guidance and practice. And I started to use this love method throughout my life to help me come back into my heart and in my body and to rewrite the narratives and the story so I could truly be aware and start to step into the role of not only the captain, but the master navigator of my life. So I have taken the last 7 years of working with VIP clients, of doing retreats and refining this methodology over and over and over again to what I believe is the most impeccable version, that has been tried and true through hundreds of clients over and over and over throughout the years. And I decided to put it into a program so I could not just help one person at a time, but I can help many people at the same time because of my mission to spread love and pleasure and awakening of humanity's consciousness at this very important time on the planet right now. I feel like we need this now more than ever. I feel like this is a time for us to step into the majesty and the worthiness that we truly deserve to receive the love, the support, the abundance, the wealth, the success that is our birthright. I created this in a way where you can bypass the pitfalls and the challenges that I face without having a guide. And you can really reap the benefits of the lessons that I learned and the gems that I excavated throughout my journey, guiding you step by step, holding your hand through the different modules and the 21 lessons that I created. And it is going to take you from a place of having uncertainty, lack of clarity or direction, lack of connection to your body. It's going to bring you into a new place of empowerment and awareness where you are going to feel, not just think, but feel this true magnetism, this powerful energy, this life force energy that is moving through you, that creates worlds in order for you to truly become a master in your life. We're going to let go of past experiences. We're going to forgive these old stories that we've been holding on to, that we weren't aware of, that may be preventing us or preventing you from receiving because you feel guilty or you feel shameful or sinful and really receiving your desires, or you feel bad for actually enjoying your life and so you can't actually enjoy your life. Maybe you're someone who feels like you want to really be expressed in your life, but you don't feel like you're supported or you don't have the confidence or the courage to step out of this place of repression and into full radical expression and acceptance. We're going to work with self-acceptance and how to own your own embodiment. We're going to move through daily practices, setting up spiritual rituals. We're going to go into a ceremonial work together as we guide in the 8 weeks, with plenty of time to integrate in between. So this is my direct personal invitation to you. Bring a friend, anyone that you feel like would benefit this. This is a journey of moving out of our fears and the road to fear and choosing to come back into our heart and into our body and truly allowing love to lead and be our guide. Because when love is leading us and it is our GPS, we can truly trust in the journey that it is taking us on. And we can allow ourselves to open up into a more full experience of surrendering into the synchronicities, the magic, the majesty, and the divine orchestration that is happening in the quantum field. So your consciousness is going to shift. This is an evolutionary journey and experience into higher dimensions of consciousness for spiritual awakening, for unstoppable self-love, and to embody these wisdoms and these teachings so you can truly stand in the world as a leader, more connected to your power, whether that's a leader in your home, whether it's a leader to your children, whether it's a leader in the classroom, your business, your relationship. But you are going to truly learn how to love yourself and choose yourself, have boundaries, and yet still have a very loving, open heart. So this is a transformative journey that starts very, very soon, within the next week. And I invite you to join me on this journey.